The Large Hadron Collider, the largest and most complex tool of modern physics. 27 kilometers circumference, 100 meters below ground, accelerating and colliding beams of particles whizzing around at nearly the speed of light. What for? To study the structure of the universe and its underlying principles. To accomplish this feat, scientists invented new technologies that were unimaginable just decades ago. This process has led to innovations in many fields, and sometimes disruptive revolutions that have changed our lives. Medicine is a prime example. Ever since Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen's accidental discovery of X-ray in 1895 and their immediate application to look inside the human body and then treat cancer, physics research has fueled medical innovations. A year later, Henry Becquerel discovered natural radioactivity in uranium, a spontaneous decay process through which some elements emit energy, or radiation, in the form of particles. Soon after, Pierre Curie and Maria Skłodowska-Curie discovered two new and highly radioactive elements, radium and polonium. Applications of radium salts were very quickly used to treat surface or body cavity tumors. Even some of the most fundamental physics discoveries have found their way into the hospital. Antimatter, a mirror twin of ordinary matter, is not just the subject of science fiction movies. It's also not something that is only found in physics laboratories. The anti-electrons, or positrons, that were postulated by Paul Dirac in 1928 and discovered by Carl Anderson in 1932, are actually used in a special type of medical imaging. Positron emission tomography, or PET, allows doctors to identify anomalies in the metabolic activity of the body, and hence to diagnose various diseases.
L'idea di utilizzare queste particelle accelerate o da ciclotroni o da sincrotroni per la terapia del cancro è dovuta a un grande fisico, Bob Wilson.
In 1946, Robert Wilson, first director of Fermilab, proposed to use protons for cancer radiotherapy. Protons can target tumors more precisely than X-rays, since they release most of their radioactive dose in the so-called Bragg peak. Today, particle accelerators, particle detectors, computing and data analysis methods are ubiquitous in hospitals and medical research centers. Conventional radiotherapy with X-rays is widely available at low cost. A limited number of facilities worldwide offer radiotherapy with protons, and an even smaller number with carbon ions, allowing to treat some of the most challenging types of tumors. New technological options are being explored to make particle therapy more widespread and affordable. New treatment modalities will also become possible, such as flash radiotherapy. Particle accelerator technology also supports nuclear medicine, which uses radioactive substances called radioisotopes for treatment and diagnosis of many diseases. A large fraction of these radioisotopes is still produced by research reactors built in the 50s and the 60s, and particle accelerators are becoming a viable option to ensure a steady supply of medical radioisotopes. Accelerator-based installations can produce innovative medical radioisotopes, which can provide more personalized diagnosis and treatment options.
The first time a PET image was ever taken at CERN of a small animal was in 1977.
Today, PET scanners use detectors based on scintillating crystals, similar to the ones used in particle physics experiments. And thanks to technologies developed initially for the LHC experiments, X-ray imaging has moved from black and white to color, providing more information. Computing and simulation techniques developed for particle physics have already been adopted in medicine. For example, to develop radiotherapy treatment plans or to simulate complex biological systems. Artificial intelligence provides new opportunities, from spotting anomalies in brain imaging, to optimizing cancer screening or stroke management, to preserving patient data privacy. For more than a century, research in nuclear and particle physics has acted as a trailblazer for disruptive technologies, which in turn have enabled crucial innovations in medicine. This collaboration is far from over.